Hey guys, this is John with Greenfish Nation. I want to welcome you to the channel today. Got a little exciting news today. My lead acid batteries on the boat have played out. They've outlived their life. Ordered some new lithiums. Got those off of Amazon just to give them a try. I've never had lithium batteries before. Plus, I didn't want to spend $1,200 a battery. So we're going to give these batteries a go. So you guys stay tuned for the review and the install of lithium batteries on the Cora Coleen. Guys, I want to welcome you to the channel again today. We're going to do the lead acid lithium swap out here on the Cora Coleen on Greenfish Nation. I've actually been looking forward to doing this for quite some time. I just never really had the reason. The batteries I had and the charger I had were working fine up until they weren't. So we went ahead and bought some lithium batteries off of Amazon. I'm going to open that up for you guys right quick. These batteries, like I said, they came off of Amazon. I paid about $350 a piece for them. They're supposed to be grade A lithium cells. You have to watch when you're buying lithium batteries and you know, some people will sell B grade cells at A grade price. Now, how am I going to tell the difference? I'm not going to be able to. I've watched a lot of reviews and people say that you really can't tell the difference in an A and a B other than they're maybe not perfectly matched. Came with an instruction manual here. We won't be needing that. I mean, if you can't hook a battery up, probably need to be doing something besides bass fishing. This is a Java Pro Energy. It's got a nice sealed pack around it. Had like 1-inch foam all the way around the battery. You got a positive and a negative terminal here. The battery is sealed. It's supposed to be no maintenance. So I'm gonna inspect my battery. I don't see any damage or anything. One of the boxes I got did have a little puncture in it, as you can see here. But I looked before I opened it and I have no damage on the battery. This is a Java Energy lithium ion, 12.8 volt, 100 amp hour. The dimensions are basically 8 by 9 by 13. It's the same as I believe a 31 class battery. Weighs 24.2 pounds. Anyway, guys, this is what our batteries look like. We got two of them. Got a 24 volt system here on the boat. So I'm gonna get this other battery out. I will tell you on these, you can go on Amazon and you can buy these in a single. You can buy them in a 2-pack, a 3-pack, or a 4-pack. If you do the math on that, it's cheaper to buy them by the single pack because you get free shipping anyway. They're upcharging you for the shipping. Even though you get free shipping, you pay more for the multi-pack battery systems, and they're exactly the same battery. They come in separate boxes and they charge you more for them. So be a smart shopper, guys. So I got these two batteries here to make up my 24 volt system. Also bought a smart charger off of Amazon. It does up to 72 volts. It'll do lead acid batteries. Let me see here. It'll do 12 volt or 24 volt lithium batteries. It'll do AGM, gel, SLA, wet, deep cycle, EFB, calcium, etc. for charging 12 volt or 24 volt lithium ion batteries as well. It says for activation or maintenance of weak, old, and idle batteries. Cannot repair severely damaged batteries, only for less. This is a HTRC smart charger. It charges all kinds of batteries. I didn't really want to pay $700 for a new 3-bank charger, so I bought this one for $84 off of Amazon. We're going to give all this stuff a try, and if it don't work, we'll put it over there with those directions in the dumpster. So you guys stay tuned for the install. Also, one more thing I did buy, I bought a battery, a smart monitor. And get this because I want to be able to put it up on the front of my boat where my trolling motor is. You guys can get the number off that if you'd like. That way I can keep a constant eye on my batteries and see how these batteries are doing. All right, guys, we're going to stick these batteries in the hole here. And put them in the same battery trays that I had them in before. All right, so I got my hot down here, my negative, my hot to jump to make the 24, and then I've got my negative down there. So these are 8mm bolts that hold all this stuff together. If you guys hadn't subscribed to our channel, I'd appreciate it if you'd hit that subscribe button. It helps our channel grow. And if you give us a like on there, that helps it as well. I did watch one review on these on YouTube, and somebody said they had one bolt that was a couple threads longer than the other, and it actually bottomed out before it got good and tight. I'm gonna say that's tight. So we'll go up front and see what our trolling motor does now. All right, guys, I'm gonna make sure my switch is turned to momentary. Turn the trolling motor all the way off. I'm gonna mash a button, make sure my prop's clear. Turn it up to 10%. We do have power. There's 20. 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 100. That's full power right there. I'm gonna say that they're just as strong as lead acid batteries, just from hearing the sound that the trolling motor normally makes. So we're gonna go back here and put our charger on there and check our voltage, so you guys stay tuned. All right, guys, we've got our smart charger here. We're gonna pull it out of the box. It has some packing in it. It also has some instructions. It's got three settings. It's got a 5-amp charge, a 10-amp charge, and a 20-amp charge. You select the battery that you're going to use to charge, and it tells you if you're charging a 20-amp, 12-volt, or a 24-amp. I'm sorry, a 10-amp, 24-volt. So let's get this hooked up. We'll check it out, and we'll get this thing up and running, guys. All right, guys, our charger, you can see, it's got a yellow plug right here on the end. Yellow plug on our cables. And they just slide right in there. On the other end, you have your 110-volt charger, and you also have a cooling fan. So we'll get that cord out, and we'll turn this thing on and fiddle around with the settings. All right, guys, y'all are seeing this live. I'm just plugging this thing up. I've never had it plugged up, so see if we can figure out what's going on here. All right, it came on. It says off, so I'm gonna hit choose the right battery. This button right here on the right, it says off. All right, so maybe it has to be hooked up to a battery, so let's go with 10 amp and 20 amp. All right, so it says it automatically, the fan automatically kicked on. Let's see here if we can choose the battery. All right, I have the lithium ion P4 is lit up and it's charging. It says it is at 27.3 volts. It's charging currently at 10 amps. And looks like everything's up and running. You could probably put this on the boat and leave it if you put it to stay. So this will tell you if it's a lithium ion, or an AGM lead battery. It knows the difference. It says we're actually charging at 8 amp hours. So I got to figure out if it's 100% when it quits blinking or if it's charging up to 100%. But I'll let you guys know. Hey guys, again, this is John with Greenfish Nation. I want to thank you for joining our channel today. Guys, we've done our Lithium Pro battery upgrade. So you guys stay tuned in the future for a review over time on these batteries, their performance, how they hold up and last. Till next time, I'm John with Greenfish Nation. I want to thank you for joining the channel today, and I want to wish all of you tight lines.